Welcome to the series of video lectures on pulse and digital circuit subject. So we are discussing chapter 1. The name of the chapter is linear wave shaping. In this chapter today, you will see the response of RC low pass circuit with pulse input. So as you know that the RC low pass circuit consisting of two passive elements. So resistor and one capacitor, where we take the output voltage across the capacitor. So this is the resistor, so this is the capacitor. Let Vi of t is the input voltage to the circuit. Because of this Vi of t, the current flowing in the loop is say I of t, and the output across capacitor is say V0 of t. So let us assume that the voltage across resistor is say Vr, the voltage across capacitor is say Vc. Now for this circuit we are applying a pulse input. As you know the definition of pulse input, so the pulse input, so this is Vi of t versus t. As you know, the pulse input maintains a constant voltage for certain duration. Its value amplitude is say from 0 to tp. So our discussion is that when pulse input is applied to this circuit, what will be the behavior of the capacitor? That means what is the expression for this output voltage and what is the waveform of output voltage? That is what our discussion today. Now, as I said many times that the input voltage at any, because it is consisting of only linear elements as well as passive elements, so at any instant of time the input voltage is equal to Vr plus Vc. So that is the fundamental property from KVL. So from any circuit, at any instant of time, at any instant of time, according to KVL, so Vi of t is always equal to Vr plus Vc. So that means if the capacitor voltage increases exponentially, so then the resistor voltage decreases exponentially, so such that the sum of these two voltages is always equal to the input voltage. So now the next point is that the time constant of the circuit is, RC circuit is tau is equal to RC. The time constant of the circuit is very simple formula, R into C tau time. Since it is a time constant, the unit is seconds. Now let us see at a different instance of time. So at a different instance of time, what will be the capacitor voltage? First let us say, first number one, say at t is equal to 0, what is the input voltage? From the diagram, the input voltage is V is equal to, Vi is equal to V. So the input voltage is V. At this time, assume that the initial voltage is across the capacitor is 0. So when you apply the input voltage at t is equal to 0, the voltage across capacitor is 0. The voltage across capacitor is 0. So therefore, the entire voltage V appears across the resistor. So therefore, Vr is equal to V. Vr is equal to V. So therefore, Vc plus Vr is equal to V. So this is true. So therefore, how to draw this waveform? So this is the waveform, how to draw like this. So let us draw this output response graph. Say this is voltage across resistor, sorry, voltage across capacitor or output. So 0, at t is equal to 0, what is, let us draw the pulse. Say this is our pulse of duration tp of amplitude V. So this is our dotted line, is your pulse input. Now at t is equal to 0, what is the output voltage? The output voltage is V. So the output voltage is 0, because the voltage across capacitor is 0. The output voltage across capacitor is 0. Now say in the interval 0 less than t less than tp, during this interval, what is the input voltage? The input voltage Vi is equal to V. So since the input voltage is constant, so as explained earlier, when the constant voltage is applied to the circuit, the capacitor charges exponentially towards the applied voltage. So when Vi is equal to V, the capacitor voltage starts increasing exponentially according to So as you know, the charging formula, is its target voltage V into 1 minus e power minus t by RC. So with this equation, the capacitor voltage starts increasing exponentially towards V. So this is how to show this waveform. This waveform is that therefore the output voltage starts increasing exponentially towards V. So this is what our expression is, V into 1 minus e power minus t by RC. So this is the expression of this graph. Now at t is equal to tp, let us call next third point. At t is equal to tp, let us see what is the output voltage. At t is equal to tp, so what is the voltage across capacitor? The voltage across capacitor is, if we substitute tp, let us call this voltage as Va. So therefore at t is equal to tp, the voltage across the capacitor or output voltage Va is equal to, so V into 1 minus e power minus tp by RC. So this is the voltage across capacitor at this time. Now let us take the next case, when the time t is greater than tp. So when time t is greater than tp, this is your input. What is the input? The input is 0. The input is 0. That is, there is no input to the circuit. The input voltage is 0. So that means, then what happens? The capacitor, because there is no input voltage, now the capacitor starts discharging exponentially. So therefore the capacitor, since the input voltage is 0, the capacitor starts discharging exponentially. The capacitor starts discharging exponentially. So according to, so the equation is V0 of t. So what is the initial, from where this capacitor starts discharging? From the voltage Va, because the voltage across capacitor is Va at this time. So this is the starting voltage. This voltage starts decreasing exponentially from the time tp. So that's why we have to take t minus tp by RC. So this is the expression with which the output starts decreasing exponentially. So therefore you can see in this graph, the output, because the input voltage is 0, the output starts decreasing exponentially according to the formula, as you know, the decreasing expression, Va into e power minus t minus tp by RC, the time constant of the circuit. Substitute, what is Va? So substitute Va in this formula. So therefore V0 of t is equal to, what is Va? V into 1 minus e power minus tp by RC. So this is the voltage at tp across the capacitor. Now this voltage decreases exponentially. So therefore e power minus t minus tp by RC. So this is the expression what you have to derive in the examination, and this is the wave equation you have to derive, very very important equation. So this is the output voltage expression, or voltage across capacitor. So this is the waveform you have to show the response of capacitor for pulse input. Now let us see finally with the different time constants, say let us case one, for example case one, if the time constant RC is much less than TP, that means the time constant is very very small when compared with the TP. Let us say this is our output graph, V0 of T versus T. So this is your pulse input. So let us draw the pulse input V. So the duration of pulse is TP, the amplitude of that pulse is V. Since the time constant is very small, what is our circuit? Our circuit is something like this, RC. Simple low pass circuit are consisting of only two elements, RC. The time constant is very small. What happens? The capacitor quickly charges to V volts. So therefore the capacitor quickly charges to V volts. So during the interval 0 to TP, the input voltage is still V. So therefore the capacitor will stay at V volts. At T is equal to TP, the input voltage suddenly becomes 0. So therefore the capacitor quickly discharges to 0. So this is the graph we have to draw very carefully. This is quick charging of capacitor, this is the quick charging of, so this is the red one is your output, the blue one, the dotted portion is your input graph. Now case 2, for example, if RC is comparable to TP, RC is comparable to TP, the time constant is comparable to TP, let us draw this graph. That is what we have drawn. So this is your pulse, input voltage, so 0, TP, this is time, this is V, so this is V0 of T. When time constant is comparable to T, so for example this is 1 millisecond, this is around 1 millisecond, the response of the graph just we have drawn, the capacitor charges exponentially towards V. When the, by this time the input voltage is 0, so therefore the capacitor, property of capacitor, discharges exponential. So this is what the two graphs you have to draw. Further case, we will take one more case, for example case 3. If the time constant RC is very greater than the pulse duration, so then last graph we will see. So this is output voltage V0 of T versus T. So this is your pulse input TP of amplitude V. Since the time constant is very large, so by the time TP, the capacitor charges to very small voltage, say like this. So therefore the capacitor takes lot of time to discharge. Something like that we have to draw when the time constant is very large. So this is what you have to draw. This is the what you have to draw about this RC low pass circuit with pulse input, the output expression and output waveforms with the different time constants. Very important question in the examination. Thank you.